What if I told you in just four simple steps you could create a fully automated imaging process for your Windows or Linux images, or even something more specific like Windows Virtual Desktop? Sounded good to be true? Well, you've never seen an image pipeline like this one. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. If you want to master the Azure Cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything. Today we want to talk about the Azure Image Builder, which is your tool to help you develop an imaging pipeline process to fully automate everything. Now, the way all image creation processes work is we start off with an image of some kind. That could be anything from an ISO of a Linux image or a Linux or Azure gallery image, or even your own custom source image. We're going to bring that into the Azure Image Builder process and then create a pipeline that's going to let us do customizations and then get that image distributed out as a virtual hard drive file, which could be used in things like Azure Stack, or you could do that as a Azure managed image and use that in the cloud, or put it in the Azure Shared Image Gallery, which is going to allow us to use it in things like Windows Virtual Desktop to keep our images up to date, or scale that image to be replicated anywhere in the world, even across multiple Azure subscriptions or Azure AD tenants. So once we have our image, we're going to build some VMs and do testing, and then this becomes an iterative process where we're going to take all of those learnings and cycle right back through our pipeline, continue to make updates to our source, customizations, testing process, and keep on distributing and improving everything. So here's the plan for today. We're going to create three Windows images. We're going to get them distributed out to at least three Azure regions. And then we're going to create a pipeline for our WVD image so that we can fully set up and deploy Windows Virtual Desktop with our optimizations, FS logics, everything. Over in GitHub, you can find the repo where all of this code comes from, and I'll have this linked in the video description. We're going to do this in two parts. We're first going to do a quick start just to get everything up and running, and then show you how to integrate this with Azure DevOps to do a full customized pipeline yourself. So in the quick starts here, we're going to do this with a Windows image, and we're going to use number one here to create a custom Windows image and the shared image gallery. So all of the code that we have for this is pulled directly from here, and I'm also going to go to shell.azure.com and sign in. So over on the right, this is the PowerShell ISE that I've got all the code set up. So I've grouped this into two sections, the top being the prereqs, and then the second section, which is the actual code execution to do everything. And we're going to just run all of this code at once. So the very first thing is the prereqs. So let's register to use the image builder, and it will come back in a few minutes and tell you that it is registering or that you're already registered. Then they have the next command, which shows whether or not you're registered, so you can check on your progress. And then after that, you just want to make sure that you're registered for these four providers so that everything is good to go. So now we're going to run everything here except for the very last commands, because that has to do with the shared image gallery. You could run that right now, but it'll just throw an error because we don't have an image in the gallery to replicate. So we'll just copy all that code into the Azure Cloud Shell. The code has finished executing by now, so it just takes a few minutes. And over here in the PowerShell, if you notice on the right, we've got this build JSON status command, and that's what you're seeing over here in the Cloud Shell right now. So the job has provisioned successfully. Its current state is running, and the substate is that the job is queued. Back in the resource group where our shared image gallery is, we've got our new image definition that is completed being set up and replicated out to our primary and secondary regions. So the process is done, and all you had to do is just sit there and let it run. Now, what can we do with it from here? If you don't have an instance of Azure DevOps, it's real easy to create one. At the search bar at the top, we'll just type in DevOps, and we'll go to our DevOps organizations, which gives us a link down here on the bottom left for my DevOps organizations. And if you don't have one, then it'll ask you to create one. And I'm going to spin up a new organization here for myself. Then you can give it a name and select whatever region you like. I'll pick Central US and hit continue. And now we need to create a project, and I'll call my new project Azure Image Builder. I'll make this a private project and we'll hit create. And in DevOps at the top right, we'll click the little marketplace icon, and then we'll browse the marketplace for an extension, and we'll search for the image builder. So go with the preview version today and click get it free, and then click to install this into your project. And then we'll click proceed to our organization, and we'll click on our project to get right back to where we were. Under our repos, we want to click initialize down here at the bottom. We're going to create a new folder, and we'll call it web app because we're going to add IIS to this server, and we'll create a new file here called default.htm as the first page. Back in the GitHub repo under the web app folder, we've got a default.htm file here, and we'll just go to raw and copy the contents, and we'll paste that into our repository. And additionally, I'll just add in one more line of HTML code here saying, welcome to my web server. We'll give the name of the server, Azure Academy Rocks. And there's the preview of what it should all look like. And once you're happy with it, hit commit. And with all good coding practices, we should add some comments. And then we'll hit the commit button. Now you want to click next to the web app folder and create a new file. And we'll call it webconfig.ps1 and hit create. Back in the repo, we'll do the same thing. Go to the raw of that particular file, copy the contents and paste it into the webconfig, add our comments and commit. Now, when this process goes through the pipeline, it's going to take this web app folder, drop it onto the virtual machine, process the PowerShell that's going to add IIS to the system, set the firewall rules, and add our default HTM for our web page. And then in the end, it should look like this. All right, with the prep work completed, now we're ready to go to pipelines and create a new release. And this is how we're going to get the magic to happen. Create a new pipeline. And at the top here, we want to select an empty job. And I'll name the stage here image build since we're creating our image with this pipeline. And at the top here, we'll click save. Then over here on the left, we'll click to add an artifact. And this will be an Azure repo. And we'll select the dropdown for our particular project. And then we'll select our source repo, our master branch, since that's the only one we have at this point. And that should also default to the latest branch for our version. And we'll click add for that artifact. Now we want to click on the build stage task. And this is where the extension from the marketplace is going to come in. So we'll click on our agent job and we want to add here and search for the image builder. And we'll select that and hit add. And now you see that some settings here need attention. That's because we have to fill all this out. Now we have to select which subscription we're going to build this in. So we want this to be the same subscription, resource group, etc., where we've got our shared image gallery. When you first select your subscription, you do need to authorize this. This gives DevOps permission to do stuff in your subscription. And once that's complete, you'll be able to select your resource group as well as your region. Now we have to paste in the resource ID from the managed identity that we gave rights into our shared image gallery. So we'll click on that, go to properties and copy the resource ID and we'll paste that. Now the pipeline needs to know what type of image we're working with. Managed image would refer to a image that's in Azure. Shared image gallery is what we're going to use today, but you could also do an Azure marketplace image. If so, you get a drop down here where you can select one of several images from the marketplace that you want to work with and customize. But because we already have a shared image gallery set up with a base image, we'll use that. We need the ID from the image version that we created in our previous task. So back in the Azure portal, we'll go to our image version. Go to properties on the left and then copy the resource ID and we'll paste that here. Scrolling down a bit more to the customize section. Now we've got to select our provisioner type. Shell would refer to bash and PowerShell is what we're going to do for Windows. And it is generally recommended to check the box for running Windows Update. That way it's something you don't have to do manually. You don't need another tool to be able to do that like Configuration Manager. It'll just happen right as part of the process. Now, as far as the build path goes, this is where we add in our customization files. So we'll click the three dots and we'll go to our linked artifacts. This is pulling directly from our repo. We'll go and click on that web app folder and there we see our default HTM and our web config. And we'll just hit OK on the web app folder. That way we capture both of those files. So for the inline customization script, this is where we tell it to kick off our PowerShell. And again, I just pulled this command right out of the GitHub repo documentation for this process. And now we have to select a storage account. We created this as part of our shared image gallery step originally. And this is where we're gonna set our distribution type. So this is gonna go again to the shared image gallery. And this image ID is for the definition. Back in the Azure portal, we'll click on our definition file, go to properties and copy the resource ID, and we'll paste that. And now we have to tell which regions we want to replicate the image into, and they should be separated by a comma. And now we'll also scale this out from going just from East and West US to include Central US as well. So now for our target VM that we're gonna provision as part of this process, by default, it's a D1 V2, but you can do whatever size you like. So I'm gonna make this a B2MS. So with that complete, we'll hit save, add any comments if you need to. And at the top, we'll click to create a release. So I've added a release note here of this is our first try, and we'll hit create. And now it's pretty much just wait and watch. We've got our image version here, and if we go to update replication, it has successfully made it to all three regions. So if we go back to the overview, we'll spin up another test VM. And once your VM is built, just copy your public IP address and open a new browser tab. And if we go to port 8080, there's our custom web page that we had set up in our DevOps repo. All right, image number three, Windows Virtual Desktop Pipeline. Here we go. So in the Azure portal, I've got a different shared image gallery that's here called Shared Image Gallery 00. I've currently got a definition here for Windows 10 and a version of that image. And I do have a managed ID and I've given it permissions appropriately so that it can control the shared image gallery. Over in Azure DevOps, we're going to create a new folder in our repo. We'll call that WBD and we'll create a new file in here called new-wbd-sessionhost.ps1. And over in my GitHub repository, I'll go into my WBD repo, into the PowerShell folder, and we'll take a look at that same file. We'll go to the raw and just copy it all, and we'll put it right into our repo. Now we do have three input parameters in this script for our profile path for FSLogix, our registration token for the host pool we're going to join, and our default for optimizations here are true. So we'll hit commit on that, and I'll add my comments and hit commit. So back on the left under pipelines, we'll go to release and we'll create ourselves a new release here. And we'll start with that empty job again and rename our stage as WVD. And over on the left, we'll click add for our artifact and pull from an Azure repo. And you could have just as easily pulled from GitHub, but just for the sake of consistency, we'll keep it as an Azure repo. We'll select our Azure Image Builder project and our source repository, pick our master branch, and again, our latest branch as our default. And at the bottom, we'll click add. Now let's click on our job here. Then we'll click our agent job again, where we have the plus to add a task. And we'll search for the image builder job and add that, and then click on it to add our settings. We need to add the resource ID for our managed identity once again, so we'll go back to the portal, grab the managed ID, go to properties, copy that resource ID back into the portal, and our image type will again be pulled from a shared image gallery. Back in the portal, we'll pull the version ID under properties, we'll copy that. Our provider will once again be PowerShell, and we will choose to run Windows Update again here. We'll select our build path and browse to our WVD folder and select that, where we'll pull in our new host PowerShell file. Now we need to add the inline customization, so we're going to need our input parameters, and we'll execute the code from cbuildartifacts/WVD. Then we need our parameters. That'll be dash profile path, and I'm putting in where my FSLogix is stored. And then we need our registration token for our host pool, and I put that here as well. And then of course we select a storage account, we'll again choose the shared image gallery, and from the Azure portal we'll grab our image definition, properties, and then resource ID, and then what regions we want this to replicate to, and we are ready to go. And at the top we'll click save, and then click to create our release, and hit create. Our job is queued, and now all we have to do is wait. And our image pipeline has completed, and we've got everything successful. So going back to the Azure portal, our image version has been deployed into the shared image gallery. Replication into the East US region is complete. And I want to show you how we're going to integrate this into an ARM template so you can do a fully customized deployment and add some extra things if you like. I'll copy the resource ID of my image version. And up in my GitHub, I'll go to my WVD repository to WVD templates. new host, and we'll scroll down and deploy a new host. Now, before I fill out the entire template, I'm going to go to edit this template. On the left, we'll go to our virtual machine, scroll down just a little bit, and we have our image reference. Now, this is pointing at the Microsoft Gallery image, and I actually want to replace that. And I can point it at the image version in the shared image gallery by using an ID. So we're good with that. Now I'll click on the last item on the left here. This is the custom script extension that was doing the work to add this to WVD, set up FSLogix, etc. before we had the Azure Image Builder. So I don't need this anymore, so I can just delete it. And since it was the last step in my process, there won't be any dependencies that I need to clean up. Hit save. Then we just fill out the template here as normal. And with that, we're ready to build. All right, with that complete, we've got our new resource group set up with our new VMs. And if we go to the host pool that we were joining them to, and now if we hit the refresh button, there we've got our new VMs from our pipeline, and let's launch our personal desktop. So keep in mind, this is the first time Black Adam is logging in, so we'll see if our optimizations worked. So everything has worked as expected. And this is, of course, just the beginning. You can take this process in any direction you want. You can add applications into your pipeline or other scripts, functionality, and then, of course, repackage everything and continue to iterate and improve this process. So I hope you've enjoyed looking at the Azure Image Builder, a way to completely automate your image pipeline so that you don't ever have to log onto a machine to set it up again. So if you learned something new today, go ahead and smash that thumbs up and let me know that you appreciated our content, as well as give me some comments down below about any questions that you have or things that you'd like to see us create for videos going forward. We've got plenty more that we could do around Azure DevOps if you're interested in that, or something else that we haven't covered yet, say something like Azure Synapse or more on containers. You just let me know what you want and I'll get it created. I'm just here to help you learn more about Azure. And speaking of learning, check out our video at the top right, which is our latest video, or the one at the bottom that our YouTube machine learning overlords have picked out just for you. Thanks very much for joining us today, and we will catch you next time. Happy learning.